Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to reaction pathway diagrams, activation energy, enthalpy changes interpretation from diagrams. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question number 8, a reaction pathway diagram is shown. We have reactants that are reacting together to form the products and products going back to the reactants. So therefore, this is a reversible reaction. Which row is correct? Now we can see that one of the arrows is going down while the other arrow is going upwards. Again, there are opposite arrows involved. So an upward arrow means that the energy is absorbed or the reaction is endothermic. While downward arrow means that the energy is released or the reaction is exothermic. Now the difference between the reactants and products is the enthalpy change. And therefore K and L are both the enthalpy changes. K is exothermic change and L is endothermic change. Coming to the options, we have to find enthalpy change of the forward reaction. Now we can see that the reactants have higher energy as compared to the energy of the products. So it means when we are converting reactants into products, the energy is released. So therefore K is the energy of the forward reaction. So A and B could be the possible options. Second point is the activation energy of the reverse reaction. In reverse reaction, we can see that the products must need this much energy in order to convert back into the reactants. So therefore, the products must absorb energy in order to go to the reactants. So therefore, O shows the activation energy of the reaction in reverse direction. You must also remember that the arrow of the activation energy is always in upward direction. So therefore, O is correct. So the correct option is B. Question 6. The reaction pathway diagram for chemical reaction is shown. On y-axis, we have energy. On an x-axis, we have progress of reaction. This is the reactant line and this is the product energy line. Which statement is correct? A. The activation energy of the forward reaction and the enthalpy change of the backward reaction have the same sign. Let's find out the activation energy for the forward reaction. Activation energy is the energy that is required by the reactants to reach the transition state. So this is activation energy and it is positive. Now the enthalpy change of backward reaction is the energy difference between the reactants and products. So the enthalpy change for backward reaction is negative as we are moving from high energy state to low energy state. So therefore they do not have same sign. So A is wrong. Part B, the activation energy of the forward reaction is more than twice the enthalpy change of the backward reaction and opposite in sign. Again, the activation energy of the forward reaction is positive while the enthalpy change of the backward reaction is negative. So it is opposite in sign. Now let's find out whether it is more than twice or not. As we can see that the activation energy of the forward reaction consists of 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, while the enthalpy change of the backward reaction consists of 2 lines. So it is exactly half of the forward reaction. So therefore we can say that it is not more than twice. It is exactly twice the enthalpy change. So B is incorrect. Part C, the enthalpy change of the forward reaction and the activation energy of the backward reaction have the same sign. Now the enthalpy change of the forward reaction is the energy difference between the reactants and products. It is positive as energy is absorbed from low energy to high energy. Now the activation energy of the backward reaction is also positive because activation energy is the amount of energy that is required by these reactants to convert into this product. So C could be true. Per D, the enthalpy change of the forward reaction is more than twice the activation energy of the backward reaction. Now, the enthalpy change of forward reaction is consisting of these two lines, while the activation energy of the backward reaction also consists of two lines, so these are actually equal. So it is not more than twice, so therefore it is incorrect. Correct answer is therefore C. Question 34, the reaction pathway diagram for a reversible reaction is shown. We have this diagram. On x-axis, we have the progress of reaction, and on y-axis, we have energy in kilojoules per mole. Which statements are correct? 1. The enthalpy change for the backward reaction is negative 20 kilojoules per mole. As we can see, this is the product, and this is the reactant. The enthalpy change is the energy difference between products and reactants. As we can see, product has more energy as compared to the energy of reactant, so therefore backward enthalpy is negative. And they have given the difference, which is 20, so therefore it would be minus 20 kilojoules per mole. So option 1 is correct. In option 2, the forward reaction is endothermic. Endothermic means that the energy is being absorbed. As we can see that the energy of reactant is lower than the energy of product, so it means that reactants have absorbed energy in this chemical reaction. So therefore the energy of product is higher, so therefore this is correct option. Third option, the activation energy for the forward reaction is plus 70 kilojoules per mole. Activation energy is the energy required by the reactants to convert into transition state. So as we know that 50 plus 20 will be the total activation energy. So 50 and 20 is equal to 70. As the arrow is upwards and reactants absorb energy in order to get into the transition state, so therefore it is plus 70 kilojoules per mole. So this is also correct. All three options are correct, so therefore answer is A. Question 33, which statements are correct for all exothermic reactions? Number 1, enthalpy change for the reaction is negative. This is a true statement because in exothermic reaction, products have lower energy as compared to reactants. As enthalpy change is equal to energy of product minus energy of reactant. So as product energy is less than reactant, so therefore it will always be negative. 2. On a reaction pathway diagram, the products are shown lower than the reactants. This is true because the energy of product is less than the energy of reactant. 3. The reaction will occur without heating. Now this statement is not true for all exothermic reactions because let's suppose we have combustion of methane. It is an exothermic reaction and we need a spark to start this chemical reaction. So this is not true for all exothermic reactions, so therefore 3 is incorrect. As option 1 and 2 are correct, the answer is therefore B. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.